Here we have an even more amazing piece. And you know, you are all some of the first ones to see these pieces.
Also noch ein beeindruckendes Bild, und wir sind welche der ersten, die das sehen.
Die ersten.
And you can see again, we have a solar system. Here is a planet with an atmosphere.
Das Sonnensystem und der Ring, den da gezeigt hat, ist ein Planet mit einer Atmosphäre.
And this planet with an atmosphere must be the Earth. We can assume it's the Earth, but it's definitely a planet with an atmosphere. There's a ship here and a ship here.
Ja, wir nehmen an, dass es die Erde ist, weil es eine Atmosphäre hat, und man sieht dann halt diese Schiffe, die Richtung Erde, weil wir es annehmen.
And there's a nice little blow-up of what's inside the dome of the ship.
Wie so eine Explosionszeichnung, also das, was innen drin ist, zeigt dann da oben halt.
In case you're confused about what it is. And this is as well, you know, you can see the steps here, typical of, pyramidal step pyramids.
Ja, man sieht da halt diese Streifen, das sieht aus wie eine Treppe, und das erinnert eben an diese Stufenpyramiden, die man über.
And here we can see that this ship is following a comet that is coming at the Earth.
Da kann man annehmen, dass das UFO im Prinzip einem Kometen folgt, der auf die Erde zusteuert.
Or at least at the planet that's here. And you can see that this UFO, right, which you can see is moving at high velocity, is doing something to push the comet.
Also wenn man sich das UFO im Endeffekt anguckt, dann kann man annehmen, dass diese Streifen von unten eine Bewegung mit einer hohen Geschwindigkeit ist und dass eine Interaktion zwischen dem Kometen und dem UFO gibt.
So this could be a representation of an event either in our past or in our future. So if here you have, you shouldn't be recording this. No recording. Okay, so here we have other pieces. Again, we have a solar system. The sun is very clear here. We have a planet with an atmosphere. We have another planet here. And we've got an ascending ship here, another one down there, and then one inside the sun flare.
Ja, im Prinzip sieht man da wieder die Sonne mit den Sonneneruptionen im Endeffekt, da dann wieder die, also der Planet mit der Atmosphäre, angenommen die Erde, andere Planeten drumherum und eben oben ein UFO, was nach oben wegfliegt, ein anderes UFO, was unten wie auch immer ist, und eins, was direkt in diesem Sonnenflare drin ist.
And as you will see in my conference, I'm going to show you the mathematics and the reason why it may be appropriate to think of the sun as a doorway to travel through our solar, through our galaxy, and even in our universe. And the ancient people always called it a doorway.
Also Nassim hat gerade einen Ausblick auf seinen Vortrag gegeben, was er da drin präsentieren will, also die Mathematik präsentieren wird, dass es möglich ist, im Endeffekt die Sonne als Portal zu nutzen, und dass das eben auch durch die alten Mythen im Prinzip beschrieben wird.
So here we see a UFO coming out of the sun. It's very specific.
Let's see what we got going on here. This is an image of behind the sun here. I'm going to scroll down. Go to the left. And what is that? Looky there. Some kind of funky looking sphere by the sun. And it doesn't just appear on the behind, it also appears on the forwards. Let me show you what I mean. This is stereo behind, here's stereo ahead. Let's do 2048 magnification on that, and we'll go down to the bottom again, and let's pick this one here, and let's see if we can find it. And in a different position, and there it is again, right there. What the hell is that? Now, you debunkers out there, explain this to me.
So here,
So
here we see a UFO coming out of the sun. It's very specific.
This is where the idea of the divine right to rule comes from. The divine right to rule because of what? Because of your bloodline, because of your DNA. This goes right back to the ancient world.
Why do we need reptiles for that? Human beings are schmucky enough to want to rule over each other.
Listen, you can tell me anything you believe, and I can start taking it apart on the basis of a little chat in front of this place. Right,
but authors all the time summarize their works in television interviews,
and that's what I'm trying to tell you.
Okay.
If you look at the ancient world, all over the ancient world, you find the same recurring story of the interbreeding between humans and non-humans, which invariably are depicted in a reptilian form, creating hybrid bloodlines, the bloodline of the gods.
And you can see on the left side down different sides of a huge stone world map. This stone world map was found in 1984 while gold digging in Ecuador in an underground tunnel system with other 350 artifacts which do not really fit any known and existing South American pre-Columbian culture. It's the backside. And you can see on the right side coming the quartz line passing in the Atlantic, a continent, Atlantis, which in our days does not exist anymore. Then the white line is crossing part of South America, and here you have a close-up and you can exactly see the Bay of Guayaquil. An inlay going up to north and a round inlay showing exactly the place where there were found those artifacts, and there is also the best quality water worldwide existing. One other very interesting artifact found on the same place in Ecuador is the so-called pyramid with the eye. The eye is an inlay, the stone is gray and white, and you have 13 steps, and it looks exactly like the pyramid with the shining eye on the $1. If you put this pyramid under black light, the eye is shining very strongly and it looks really like an eye, but not real like a human eye. Here you have a close-up of the eye and you can see the colors of the inlay. On the bottom of this pyramid, you have the inlay in little gold plates showing the Orion star constellation, and you have unknown writing. The translation of Professor Kurt Schildmann, who was the president of the German Linguistic Association, and he was perfect in more than 40 languages, he was able to translate this writing. He called it pre-Sanskrit because it is older than the oldest writing. And the translation of these four letters you can see here, his translation is "the Son of the Creator comes." This is one of several very, very strange skulls. They are presented in a small museum in Ica in Peru. Ica is located close to the famous Nazca lines, and the museum is called Museo Maria Reiche, the German lady who was researching her whole life about the Nazca lines. And in this museum you can see the most strange skulls I ever saw, all found in this area close to the Nazca lines. So the question is, what kind of humans were living there and how did they get those skull forms? And especially this one, definitely several doctors and experts told me it would not be possible to create such a kind of deformation, because through deformation you do not get the double bone material on the skull, and on this skull even you have particles of the skin and hairs, and I think it would not be difficult to do an age dating and especially a DNA analysis of this skull. On this picture I show you some legendary skeleton forms of giants. In the year of 1964, in the south of Ecuador, in the province Loja, there broke down a part of a mountain platform, and Father Carlos Vaca, who was working as a priest in hospitals, he was called to this place and he found the broken bones of a giant.